Okay, number four, they give us, the first term is 2, okay? So just a notation then, if the first term is 2, that's what we call a sub 1, okay? What do you think the next term would be? A sub 2. And the next term?
A sub 3.
There you go. And what about just that term out there somewhere?
A-N.
A sub N. So N is a letter we like to use when we're talking about just sequences of numbers, okay? So N is like an arbitrary number out there. So A sub 1, A sub 2, A sub 3, and so on and so on. The common difference, they say, is 11. As we briefly mentioned, that common difference is just the difference between this term and the term before it. Basically, they're just telling you what the pattern is. It goes up by 11. So the next term would be what?
13.
And it goes up by 11 again. We're at
34.
And it goes up by 11 again. We're at 35. What are we even supposed to do here? Right, the next three terms of the arithmetic sequence, that's exactly what we did. The next three terms would be a sub 2, a sub 3, and a sub 4. That make sense? Not too bad? Applying that pattern is simple. It's really just a matter of knowing the vocabulary. The vocabulary of the common difference means the number that I would add to get the next term. It's called the difference. Because if I take any term and subtract the term before it, example, 24 minus 13, the difference is 11. And it's common to any pair of sequential terms, any terms that follow each other right in order like that. Equation for the nth term of the arithmetic sequence and find a sub 10. What does a sub 10 mean?
This 10th
term. 10th term. Term would be the right word to use. Let's say the 10th number. The 10th. I don't know whether the word is that when you go besides term or number. What's the pattern here? Go down by 3. Subtract 3 to get to the next number. Say, well, let's find a sub 10, right? Just using that pattern. If I were to do that, I could start at negative 3, the number negative 3, and, well, I could subtract 3, right?
Yeah.
That would give me to the second term. If I subtract 3 again, what's that do?
Third term.
Get to the third term, subtract 3 again, get you to the fourth term, right? And so, by doing this, subtracting 3 multiple times, we've gotten to the fourth term. Notice we started with negative 3. It's a coincidence that the first term is negative 3, and then we subtract 3. So concentrate on this. We subtracted 3 how many times?
3.
And which term did it get us to?
3, 12.
Which term is that?
4.
The fourth one. It's a sub 4. If I subtract 2 3s, that gets me to a sub 3. If I subtract 1 3, it gets me to a sub 2. In the case of 1, if I subtract no 3s. Okay. So how many 3s would I have to just subtract to get all the way to a sub 10?
10.
10? Start here. If I subtract 3 once, this is the pattern we're trying to notice here. If I subtract 3 once, it gets me to the second term. 1, 3, subtract 1, 3, it gets me to the second term.
9.
Subtract 2, okay. We'll all agree. We realize now it would only take 9 subtracting threes to get to the 10th term. Should I write all that down? Should I subtract 3 and then write this like 6, 4, 3? Of course not. What's faster than that?
Multiplication.
So I want to subtract 3 9 times, times 9. So I call it times 9. Negative 3 minus 3 times 9, that's negative 3 minus 27, that's negative 30. Yeah?
Yep.
30. Okay, so we found a sub 10. That's great. We're all supposed to, we're supposed to find a formula. Okay, you can always find a formula, you can generate a formula by just trying it several times in a row and noticing here are the parts that stay the same, here are the parts that change. The parts that change, I should use variables to represent. Okay. So if I was to go to try to find a sub 15, a sub 15, okay, a sub 15, what would that look like? It would look somewhat similar to this, but also some things would be different. Charlie?
Well, the A1 would be added.
So we have the negative 3 to start with.
And then you add it with n minus 1 in parentheses.
Okay, n minus 1.
And then you're supposed to multiply by d, which is the difference, and then it takes you to negative 3.
Okay, why n minus 1, Charlie?
Well, you're starting on negative 3, so that's subtracting 1 from the A15 or A10.
Why is it subtracting 1?
Because you're starting on the first one, so you're not counting it.
Okay. Yeah, we wouldn't count the first one, we just count how many times we have to go up to get to the nth term, right? So what's n in this case?
A 10 or a 15.
Well, right there it's 15. 15, negative 3, plus 14 times negative 3. So this number here, it's always one less than the number of the term that you're trying to get to if you start at figure number 1. Right? So negative 3 minus 42. That equals negative 45. Negative 45 is the 15th term in this sequence. So if I just try to generalize that, to the nth term, I'm trying to get all the way down to the nth term, whether it's 10 or 15 or whatever, I always am going to subtract 3 times 1 less than the number of the term I'm trying to get to. So we start at negative 3, and we're going to subtract 3 times, what would this be?
N minus 1.
N minus 1. Because the number of times we have to subtract 3, if we're starting from the first term, the number of times we have to subtract 3 is 1 less than whatever the term is we're trying to get to. Let's try thinking of it this way. Because I have the feeling of people needing a formula or thinking they need a formula when they definitely don't. Not thinking about, you know, why it even makes sense. Formula exists for a reason. Sometimes formulas are given to us by people who are very smart, and those formulas are very difficult to understand. But this formula is really not. Okay? So let's imagine instead of starting at the first term, we start at this third term. We're going to start at negative 9.
Please excuse the interruption. Will you please release the high school
So we're going to start at negative 9. If I want to get to the next term, still, subtract 3. Right? Get to the term after that, subtract another 3. Get to the term after that, subtract another 3. We're all following here. That makes sense. We're trying to get to the 12th term, and we're starting right here. I'm going to subtract 3, and I'm going to subtract 3 again, and I'm going to subtract 3 again, and I'm going to subtract 3 again. Well, how many times would I have to subtract 3 to get from a sub 3 to a sub 4, a sub 5, a sub 6, a sub 7, a sub, all the way to a sub 12, right?
9
times?
Or
who agrees with that? It would be 9 times?
Or 8.
It would be 8 times?
3.
3. We're starting at the third term. We're going to subtract 3.
Oh.
Once would get us to this term. Twice would get us to the fifth term. 3 times would get us to the sixth term. So how many times would it take to get to the 12th?
9.
Back to 9? We agree with 9?
Yes.
Yeah, it would be 9. We would have to go up. We'd have to move down a line 9 terms to get to the 12th term from the third term. Okay, so minus 3 times 9. And so negative 9 minus 27, negative 36. Yeah, negative 36. So we could write an a sub n out of this too. Right? If I start at negative 9, negative 9 is the third term. Well, I'm still going to start at negative 9 and subtract 3 multiple times. But how many times would it be to get to figure number n, or term number n? Like how many times would I subtract 3 if I'm starting at figure 3? To start at 3 and go to 12, it took 9. How'd you get 9?
You would just add like kind of subtract 9 to 8, 3.
So you just kind of guessed like 9, I think, and then went up 3 from there? Okay. Well, how many steps would it take to get to the fourth term from the third term? 1. I'm going to get to the fourth term. That only took 1 step. That's 3 less than 4. What if I want to get to a sub 5? That would just take 2 more steps, right? I'm going to get to a sub 5, and that would take just 2 steps. 5, right? And it only takes 2 steps. We don't count those first 3. So, if I were to plug n right there, like 12 right there, what would I have to subtract from it?
3.
So here's another formula. Negative 9 minus 3 times n minus 3. And if we were to multiply this out, like distribute this negative 3, a sub n equals negative 9. Negative 3 times n is negative 3n. Negative 3 times negative 3 is positive 9. Negative 9 plus 9 is 0, so a sub n equals negative 3n. Just negative 3n, which makes sense. Like if I just back up one term, what term would this be? If we follow the pattern of a sub 4, a sub 3, a sub 2, a sub 1, a sub what?
0.
A sub 0. Well, what number would that be that I would go down, down 3?
Zero.
It would just be, in this case, 0. A sub negative 1. We could go to a sub negative 1. We can keep following that pattern infinitely in that direction, too. But if we start at a sub 0, the nice thing is it takes 1 step to get to term number 1, 2 steps to get to term number 2. So the n and the number of steps that we need to take, or the number of 3s that we need to subtract, is the same. Let's look at another one. We've seen that enough. Write a equation for finding the nth term and find an a sub 10. Let's start at 10, of course. And how much do we have to add on to get to the next one?
1.
We add on 1. And so this is 11. Now we're at 11. What would I do with 11 to get to 12? Add another 1. Now we're at 12, what would we do to get to 13?
Add another
one.
This is getting boring, huh? Add one, add one, add one. How many ones did we just add?
Three, pay close attention.
Three ones. Which term does that get us to?
13.
A4.
Yeah, the fourth one, the fourth term, which is 13. Okay, so three, add on three ones gets you to the fourth term, right? They're one away from each other, which makes sense because we started here at the first one. Let's think of this differently.
Erase, erase, erase.
This is a sub one,
a sub two, a sub three, a sub four.
Can we back up?
Yes.
What is that? A sub zero, and what number is it?
Nine.
Now we start at nine. And we add one. That gets us to 10.
A sub
1. And how many ones did we add?
1.
Add 1. 1. We're up to term number 1. So that's a convenient little, like, if I want to get to A sub 1, add on just 1 once. Okay? If I add on 1 2 times, that gets me to term 2. If I add it on 3 times, it gets me to term 3. So that's kind of nice, because like the n and the number of 1s I add are the same, instead of being 1 off of each. So my formula, right, like for this example, a sub 10, which we're supposed to find, would be 9 plus what?
Plus 10.
Plus 10.
Yeah, 1 times 10. I'm going to add 1 10 times. Of course, that's just 10. So a sub n, notice that this guy here and this one here are the same. They're the same. I add on just as many of the common difference as the number of the term I'm looking for. So a sub 10 is 9. Right there. Plus
what?
10. Well, not 10, because I'm not trying to get to 10, I'm trying to get to n.
9 plus n.
Oh, okay.
Plus n.
9 plus
n.
N. And it's just n because it's the common difference is just 1.
Yep.
So just add on the number of the term and I get there. Okay. Kind of a silly common difference, but fine. Alright, 39. Movie earns $100 million the first week it's released. The movie earns $20 million less each additional week. Write an equation for the nth term of the arithmetic sequence. Ooh. So instead of writing like 100 million, let's just write 100 and understand it means 100 million. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Okay. So the number that appears is the number of millions of dollars. So the first week, $100 million, and then the next week it makes some money, but it makes $20 million less than that. So how much money did it make?
It made
80. It made 80. $80 million. So week number one, week number two, week number three?
60.
We're getting the idea. Week number three. Well, to figure out how many millions of dollars this thing made in week whatever, we are just going to subtract 20s until we get down to that term that we're talking about. We'll start at 100. And just as an example, let's get to a sub 4. Start at 100 and subtract 20. How many times do we subtract 20 to get to term number 4?
3.
What's that? Would be 3 times. Because I would subtract 20 once to get to the second term. Notice one time gets me to the second term, two times gets me to the third term, three times would get me to the fourth term. I subtract 20 once, twice, three times to get to the fourth term. So subtract 20 three times. Notice how the fourth term and this three are one off of each other, because we're starting at week number one. A sub n would be 100 minus 20 times a number that's 1 less than whatever that number is. Whatever that number is. If it's 4, that'll be 3. If it's 5, that'll be 4. If it's 6, this will be 5. So what do I put here so that it'll translate this n into a number that's 1 less than that? Josie?
N minus 1.
N minus 1 inside the parentheses. So you can see I'm inside the parentheses. Whoever uses this formula, although try to find a sub 5, they'll put 5 right there. Subtract 1, it's inside the parentheses, whatever operation says, that comes first. 5 minus 1, is gonna be 4, negative 20 times 4 is gonna be negative 80, 100 minus 80, 20. So we find it makes 20 million, and we make $20 million. So a sub n equals 100 minus 20 times n minus 1. Or we can distribute this negative 20, so 100, negative 20 times n is negative 20n, negative 20 times negative 1 is positive 20, so a sub n is 120 minus 20n. Now, we're talking about movies and the number of weeks that it's, like, which week the movie is out, right? The first week is the first week that it's out. So, this doesn't make a lot of sense, but if we back up one, we're at the zero turn, a sub zero. What would that have to be if this pattern is true? We're down 20 each time, Blake?
It'd be
120. Yeah, 120. And take a look at what our formula says, 120 minus 20 times n. It would be minus 20 times n. We'd subtract 20. 1, 2, 3, 4 times to get to term number 4. So the term number and the number of times that we subtract 20 match up. They're the same. This formula is perfect. This formula also perfect. Either one is fine. The formula 80 minus 20 times parentheses n minus 2, also perfectly fine working formula. Works.
You guys realize this is 100%
accurate. I think that's it. Are there any questions? Make sense. Are you all experts on arithmetic sequences? Difference, a sub 1, a sub 2, a sub n. Kids? I don't have anything, so I mean, like, if you don't have anything, I don't know. Yeah, do you have, like, the word equation or the formula process?
Formula.
Formulas. Because, like I said, this formula, we just wrote it without having to worry about, like, what does the book tell me to do. I'm not against, you know, are you reading the book, of course, but look at how this matches up with what we just did 3 times. Okay, so this previous one. So, here we are, week number 1, $100 million. Right? So we started with $100 million. Okay? That's a sub 1. A sub 1, $100, $100 million, okay? Then, let's back up. I mean, if we switch this around a little bit to say plus n minus 1 times negative 20, okay? Because negative 20 is the common difference. Negative 20 is what takes me to the next term in the sequence, right? So here's a sub 1, here is d. Here is, well, n minus 1, because, of course, we started on the first term, and it would take 1 less than whatever number of the term we want to get to. So can we use that? Of course, but there is right there for us to just think for a few minutes and come up with it. And like I said, sometimes formulas, they're pretty crazy. Like, here's a crazy one. We can derive, we can come up with it, but man, it's pretty tricky. Here's the formula. See, now I minus the square root, b squared, minus 4ac over 2a. Okay. So this is an algebra formula, right? This formula allows us to solve this equation. Ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0. So that's the formula for solving this equation. This formula is a bit nuts. To derive it is definitely possible. It is not too hard, but I wouldn't expect you to derive it every time. So this is one where I say, hey, you should memorize this just so that you have it, right? I have it memorized. I didn't derive it just now. I memorized it. But this one, sure need the book to tell me or somebody to tell me what the formula is for doing a thing. This thing is easy enough to understand. We can come up with the formula on our own every time. Every single time. All I need to know is that I'm going to start somewhere. I'm going to add a number. That number might be negative. This many times. And add on this number this many times. That's my 2 cents about that. And, you know, things like that, like this formula here, the first few times we have it on a test, I'll just put it on the test so that you don't have to worry about memorizing it. This one, I won't.